Welcome to our Mystery Sleep Stories channel, your sanctuary for meditation and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this quest for deep sleep. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our mystery bedtime stories. So, let the tale begin. The Mystery of the Lost Mayan City. Chapter 1. Into the Heart of the Jungle. Dr. Alex Ramirez, an esteemed archaeologist known for his expertise in Mesoamerican cultures, stood at the edge of the vast Guatemalan jungle, the gateway to an adventure that could redefine his career. Rumors of a lost Mayan city whispered in academic circles and among local villagers had brought him here, fueled by a mix of professional ambition and personal intrigue. Alex had spent years studying the Maya, their enigmatic glyphs, elaborate rituals, and advanced astronomical knowledge. This rumored city, if it existed, could be a treasure trove of information, potentially unlocking secrets of the Mayan civilization that had baffled historians for centuries. The small village at the jungle's edge was abuzz with activity. Alex had assembled a diverse team for the expedition. Luis and Maria, local guides who knew the jungle's treacherous terrain like the back of their hands. Dr. Emily Carter, a fellow archaeologist and longtime colleague specializing in ancient Mesoamerican languages. And a few graduate students eager to partake in what could be a groundbreaking discovery. As they prepared to embark, Alex briefed the team on their route, based on old maps, legends, and his research into Mayan symbology. The journey ahead promised to be arduous, traversing dense jungle, navigating through uncharted territory, and deciphering clues hidden in the landscape. Their first challenge was the jungle itself. It was a living entity, a maze of towering trees, tangled vines, and hidden creatures. The air was thick with humidity, and the chorus of wildlife created a soundtrack that was both haunting and exhilarating. As they ventured deeper, the team encountered remnants of the Mayan civilization. Fragments of pottery, pieces of obsidian, and ruins overtaken by the jungle. Each discovery was a piece of the puzzle, and Alex meticulously documented everything, knowing that even the smallest artifact could be a vital clue. One such clue was an intricate glyph they found on a partially collapsed stela in a clearing. Emily, with her expertise in Mayan languages, identified it as a reference to a Mayan deity associated with astronomy. This discovery reinforced Alex's theory that the lost city could have been an astronomical center. The expedition's pace was slow, hindered by the dense foliage and the need for careful examination of potential clues. Each evening, as they set up camp, Alex would pore over his notes, piecing together the information they had gathered during the day. Several days into their journey, the team stumbled upon a series of stone structures, half swallowed by the jungle. These were unlike any known Mayan ruins, featuring unique architectural elements. Excitement surged through the team as they realized they might be on the brink of a significant discovery. However, their excitement was tempered by a growing sense of unease. They noticed signs of being followed, unfamiliar footprints, subtle disturbances in the foliage. Alex couldn't shake off the feeling that they were not alone in the jungle, that someone else was was after the lost city. One night, their fears materialized. A shadowy figure approached their campfire, warning them of the dangers ahead. He spoke cryptically of the city's curse and vanished into the night as quickly as he had appeared. This mysterious encounter left the team rattled, with questions about the figure's identity and intentions. Despite the warning, Alex's resolve only strengthened. He knew the risks involved in their quest, but the potential rewards, unraveling the secrets of a lost civilization, were too great to ignore. The days that followed were a blend of discovery and tension. The team unearthed more clues, fragments of a mural depicting celestial events, a series of glyphs telling an incomplete story, and ancient pathways leading deeper into the jungle. Their progress was halted when they came across a river, its currents too strong to cross without proper equipment. Alex and Luis scouted for a crossing point, eventually finding a narrower section upstream. The crossing was risky, but it was their only way forward. With ropes and makeshift rafts, they managed to cross the river, but not without incident. Maria suffered a minor injury, a stark reminder of the expedition's dangers. Despite the setback, the team's spirits were buoyed by the sight that greeted them on the other side. A valley that perfectly matched a description in an ancient Mayan text, suggesting they were close to their destination. Finally, Alex and his team set up camp in the valley, under a starlit sky, the lost city seemingly within their reach. But the mystery of their shadowy follower and the enigmatic warning loomed over them, adding an air of suspense to their quest. Chapter 2, Unraveling the Clues. As dawn broke over the verdant valley, Dr. Alex Ramirez and his team prepared for another day of exploration. The discovery of the valley, so closely matching the ancient Mayan texts, had reinvigorated the team. Alex felt they were on the cusp of a monumental discovery, one that could change the understanding of the Mayan civilization. The team ventured deeper into the valley, guided by the clues they had gathered. The dense jungle canopy above filtered the sunlight into a kaleidoscope of light and shadows, creating an almost mystical atmosphere. The air was filled with the sounds of wildlife and the distant, echoing calls of howler monkeys. As they trekked, they came across a series of stone carvings, partially hidden by overgrowth. These carvings depicted various Mayan gods and celestial bodies, further reinforcing the theory that the lost city had significant astronomical importance. Emily, with her expertise in Mayan languages, interpreted the glyphs, revealing a narrative of star alignments and their influence on Mayan rituals. The team's progress was slow yet steady, with each discovery adding to their understanding of the path to the city. The jungle, however, was unforgiving. They contended with swarms of insects, treacherous terrain, and the relentless humidity, which took its toll on their stamina and resolve. Their journey was marked by moments of wonder and trepidation. At one point, they stumbled upon an ancient altar, its surface adorned with intricate reliefs and long-faded stains that spoke of past ceremonies. Alex couldn't help but feel a deep connection to the people who had once stood at this very spot, performing rituals that were integral to their culture and beliefs. As they moved forward, the signs of someone else following them became more evident. Unusual markings on the trail, the occasional glimpse of movement in the the periphery of their vision, and a general sense of being watched kept the team on edge. The mysterious figure who had warned them earlier remained an enigma, his intentions unclear. One evening, as they gathered around the campfire, the team discussed their theories about the lost city. They speculated about its purpose, its inhabitants, and the reasons for its eventual abandonment. The discussions were lively, with each member bringing their expertise and perspective to the table. That night, their camp was disturbed by an unexpected visitor. A local indigenous man, who introduced himself as Ixchel, approached them. He spoke of the legends passed down in his community, tales of a city that was a nexus of Mayan knowledge and spirituality. Ixchel offered to guide them, claiming to know the path to the city. Skeptical yet intrigued, Alex and the team agreed to accept Ixchel's guidance. The next day, with Ixchel leading, they ventured into a part of the jungle that was denser and more enigmatic. The vegetation here was thicker, and the air had an almost tangible sense of history. Ixchel led them to a series of hidden caves. Inside, the walls were covered with paintings and glyphs that told stories of Mayan gods, creation myths, and the cycles of life and death. It was a treasure trove of information, a direct link to the Mayan worldview and cosmology. Amidst these ancient narratives, they found a recurring symbol, a jaguar with two stars for eyes. Ixchel explained that this symbol was associated with a Mayan deity linked to the night sky and the underworld. This clue was the key they had been searching for, pointing them directly to the heart of the lost city. The following days saw them navigating through a labyrinth of dense jungle and hidden pathways, each step taking them closer to their goal. The sense of being followed persisted, but Ixchel's presence gave them an added sense of security and purpose. Finally, after days of arduous travel, the team emerged into a clearing, and before them lay the ruins of the lost city. It was a breathtaking sight: stone pyramids, grand plazas, and towering statues, all overtaken by the jungle, but still standing proudly, testaments to the ingenuity and artistry of the Maya. As they explored the ruins, the scale and complexity of the city became apparent. It was clear that this had been a center of significant importance, religious, astronomical, and cultural. The architecture was aligned with celestial events, and the numerous carvings and statues depicted a rich tapestry of mythological narratives. Alex and the team set up a base camp near the city's central plaza. They began a systematic exploration of the site, documenting their findings and uncovering the layers of history buried within. Their exploration, however, was not without challenges. The rival archaeologists, now clearly identified as their followers, made their presence known. They were after the city's artifacts, looking to plunder its treasures for their gain. Finally, Alex and his team stand at the precipice of a major archaeological discovery, their excitement tempered by the looming threat of those who would seek to exploit the city's secrets for personal gain. The mystery of the lost city was unraveling, but so were the dangers that accompanied such a monumental find. Chapter 3: The City Revealed. In the heart of the jungle, surrounded by the towering remnants of the lost Mayan city, Dr. Alex Ramirez and his team were awestruck by the magnitude of their discovery. The city, a labyrinth of temples, plazas, and residences, was more extensive and well-preserved than they had dared to hope. It was a silent witness to a forgotten past, waiting for its stories to be told. As the team set about their exploration, they uncovered remarkable artifacts and structures that shed light on Mayan life and culture. One of the most significant finds was a series of frescoes in a temple that depicted the Mayan creation myth, providing invaluable insights into their religious beliefs and cosmology. The team also discovered an observatory with an intricate alignment to celestial bodies, reinforcing the Mayan reputation as exceptional astronomers. Alex was particularly fascinated by a series of glyphs that hinted at the city's role in regional politics and trade, suggesting it was once a hub of Mayan civilization. However, the excitement of these discoveries was overshadowed by the looming threat of the rival archaeologists, who had now become more brazen in their attempts to reach the city. Their presence was a constant reminder of the potential danger to both the team and the invaluable cultural heritage they were unearthing. One night, the tension came to a head when the rival group launched a raid on the team's camp, attempting to steal artifacts and research. A skirmish ensued, and though Alex and his team managed to fend off the attackers, the incident left them shaken and underscored the need for increased vigilance. Following the attack, Alex held a meeting with his team to discuss their next steps. They were torn between the desire to continue their work and the responsibility to protect the site from further plunder. It was during this meeting that Ixchel, their indigenous guide, spoke up. He emphasized the sacredness of the city to his people and pleaded for its protection. The team agreed that safeguarding the site was paramount. They decided to document as much as possible and to take only photographs and minimal samples for further study. The larger artifacts and structures would remain untouched, preserved in their historical context. With this renewed sense of purpose, the team intensified their documentation efforts. They mapped the city, recorded every carving and inscription, and used technology to create 3D models of the structures. Every step was taken with the utmost respect for the site's cultural and historical significance. As they worked, they uncovered more about the city's history. They found evidence of trade with other Mayan cities, a complex water management system, and indications of a sudden, unexplained abandonment. Alex hypothesized that a combination of environmental changes and political strife might have led to the city's decline. The team's work, however, was interrupted by the arrival of local authorities, alerted to the situation by the skirmishes, and the presence of unauthorized individuals in the area. The authorities, recognizing the significance of the discovery, agreed to help protect the site. With official protection in place, Alex and his team were able to complete their initial study of the city. As they prepared to leave, they felt a mix of accomplishment and regret. There was so much more to learn from this ancient city, but they were leaving it behind to ensure its preservation. Finally, Alex looks back at the hidden city one last time, feeling a profound connection to the past. He knew that their discovery would open a new chapter in understanding the Mayan civilization, and that the true value of their find was in the knowledge and history it represented, not the artifacts themselves. Chapter 4, Protecting the Past. In the aftermath of the confrontation with the rival archaeologists and the intervention of the local authorities, Dr. Alex Ramirez and his team prepared to leave the jungle with a wealth of knowledge, but also a heavy sense of responsibility. The lost city, a testament to a bygone era, was now exposed to the modern world, and its protection was paramount. Back in civilization, Alex found himself thrust into the limelight. News of the discovery had spread, capturing the imagination of the public and the academic world. While the excitement of uncovering a lost Mayan city was overwhelming, Alex was more concerned about the site's preservation and the ethical implications of their find. In a series of meetings with local government officials, archaeologists, and representatives from international preservation societies, Alex advocated for the site's protection. He emphasized the importance of leaving the artifacts in their original context for future study, and proposed that the site be turned into a protected archaeological park. His proposal was met with various challenges. There was the temptation to excavate the site for artifacts that could be displayed in museums or sold to private collectors. There were also logistical and financial considerations in maintaining and protecting a remote archaeological site. However, Alex's passionate arguments, backed by his team's detailed documentation and the support of the local indigenous community, eventually swayed the authorities. A plan was set in motion to declare the city a protected site with controlled access for further scientific study. With the future of the lost city secured, Alex focused on sharing their findings with the world. He and Dr. Emily Carter co-authored a series of papers detailing the city's architecture, art, and glyphs, providing new insights into Mayan culture and history. They presented their findings at conferences and public lectures, bringing the story of the lost city to a global audience. The local community was significantly impacted by the finding as well. The location became a source of pride and a representation of the area's rich cultural legacy. Their guide, Ixchel, collaborated with the authorities to make sure his people were part of the site's upkeep and preservation, encouraging a feeling of responsibility and reconnection with their ancestry. For Alex, the expedition had been a transformative experience. He had started as an archaeologist seeking to uncover the past, but he had become an advocate for preserving history for future generations. The journey had taught him that the true value of archaeological work lies not in the extraction of artifacts, but in the understanding and respect for the cultures they represent. As he prepared for his return to the United States, Alex reflected on the impact of their discovery. He realized that their work had just begun. The lost city had opened up new avenues for research and had raised important questions about the Mayan civilization and its interactions with the environment and neighboring cultures. The story concludes with Alex back at his university, planning his next expedition. He had new goals now, to explore and understand, but also to protect and preserve. The lost city was a reminder of the fragility of history and the importance of respecting the past. As he looked at the maps and notes spread out on his desk, Alex felt a deep connection to the ancient world he had briefly been a part of. He knew he would return to the jungle, not just as an archaeologist, but as a guardian of history, dedicated to uncovering its secrets while ensuring its survival for generations to come.